Hello everyone, welcome to the latest episode of All This Science, the science podcast that describes an interesting aspect of science in 5 minutes or less. My name is Michael and I will be your guest podcaster host for today, and joining me will be my special guest, Dr. Owen Jowett.
Hey Mike, thanks for having me on the show.
Of course, thanks for joining us here at All This Science today. The other day, I put out a list of potential topics for the next segment and let the viewers decide what topic they would like discussed on the podcast. As it turns out, the science behind cologne was the most popular choice, raking in over 50% of the votes. That is why we brought you in here, Dr. Jowett. Now, can you tell me a bit about what you do?
It's great to hear that so many people were interested in learning more about cologne. As far as my job goes, I am what you would call a perfumer. My job involves testing and evaluating various fragrances for different companies before they hit the market. I'm in charge of quality control and market research. I've even launched my own cologne fragrance known as El Passion.
Wow, that's very fascinating. And what kind of education is needed to work a job like that?
I have a master's and a PhD in cosmetic sciences. I chose to specialize in fine fragrances such as cologne and perfume, and I wrote my thesis on the evolution of perfume.
I see. So compared to you, I know absolutely nothing about colognes and fragrances. However, I do appreciate a nice scent when I smell one. I'm curious, what gives my cologne its nice smell?
There are a mind-blowing amount of chemicals that are used for just one simple scent. According to research done by The Guardian, fragrance formulations are considered a trade secret, so companies will not disclose all the chemicals that go into it. The perfume industry is similar to the food industry in that a good chef will not reveal the secret ingredient to a great recipe.
Wow, that's an interesting analogy. Well, if that's the case, what are some chemicals that are common among most, if not all, fragrances?
According to Alatura Naturals, some common chemicals found in most fragrances include acetone, ethanol, benzaldehyde, methylene chloride, camphor, and lots more. Alcohols are used as well to spread out the smells so you are able to distinguish them more easily.
Wow, that's very interesting. But you're going to give me a seizure with all those big words there. Speaking of seizures, are there any potential health risks that come with using perfume regularly?
That's a great question, Mike. Many large perfume companies face controversy because by choosing not to reveal their secret ingredients, the public does not know what chemicals they may be. So, it begs the question if they are harmful to us or not. As far as I'm concerned, perfumes are perfectly safe as long as they are not digested.
Okay, so basically, colognes and perfumes nowadays are quite safe. But what about fragrances back in the day? Can you tell us a bit about the history of cologne?
Another great question, Mike. You are really on the ball today with these questions. Personally, I find the history of cologne to be very fascinating. According to research done at McGill University, the first form of cologne was produced roughly 4,000 years ago by the Mesopotamians. Then, the Egyptians adopted it as well about 1,000 years later. They would use it for religious ceremonies and rituals. Further along in time, nearing the 19th century, fragrances were significantly changed as scientists' understanding of chemistry drastically improved. Back then, a given fragrance would be derived from a single flower, whereas today's fragrances are immensely complex, formed with a great number of different natural and synthetic chemicals.
Well, there you go. That's a lot to think about, folks. While you digest all this science, we'll take a quick commercial break.
This podcast is brought to you by El Passion. Fragrance for men. Smell as good as the man you've always wanted to be.
And we're back. A big thank you to El Passion Fragrances for sponsoring our podcast. Let's get right back into perfume with the next question. Something that I've always wanted to know, Dr. Jowett, is what is the big difference between cheap and expensive cologne? Is it worth splashing your big bucks on the latest Versace cologne?
Well, Mike, I'm glad you asked. The answer to that question comes down to personal preference. However, there are a few differences to keep in mind. According to the perfume shop, expensive colognes are engineered to have multiple part smells, and they typically separate them into three notes. The first being upon the application. The fragrance evaporates into your skin within the first 15 minutes. This stage is known as the top note. The second stage is the heart note, which is the scent that appears 3 to 4 hours after application. The scent that you will remember. Finally, there's the base note, which is the longest lasting scent, sticking tightly to your skin roughly 5 to 8 hours after application. Woody and musky scents are commonly used for the base note. Compared to the expensive colognes, the notes of cheap colognes don't have the same duration, forcing you to have to reapply every 1 to 2 hours.
To me, it sounds like there's a clear quality difference between cheap and expensive colognes. So just to confirm, you're saying that buying a more expensive cologne is a worthwhile investment?
I don't speak for everyone, but generally, if you're looking to buy a cologne and you want to get a bang for your buck, I say go ahead and splash those big bucks on the Versace cologne. However, one more thing to keep in mind before making your purchase is the branding. Some colognes are more expensive purely because the people are willing to pay for the brand name, so it's always best to consider all of your options.
Great. I will make sure to keep all of this in mind ahead of my big date tonight. Thank you so much for your time, Dr. Jowett. It was a pleasure meeting you and having you on the show. Thanks for listening to All This Science. Make sure to contact us at allthisscience@gmail.com if you'd like to learn more about what we do here.